Crafoord Laureates in Astronomy for 2024 have made it possible to explore the inside of our Sun and distant stars. Douglas Gough, Jørgen Christensen-Dalsgaard and Conny Aerts have developed the field of asteroseismology to make the invisible visible.
Yeah, so astronomy is a very old science, but new methods are developed, and with astroseismology, these laureates have given us a new way to study the universe.
The laureates are, of course, very worthy recipients of the Crafoord Prize, having opened this window to the interior of the Sun and the interior of the stars.
The laureates wanted to study the inside by examining the outside. Imagine hitting two spheres with a wooden mallet. The sound alone tells you which one is made of metal or wood. Celestial bodies also resonate with sound at different frequencies and amplitudes. On Earth, seismology uses this to study the interior of our planet. The interior of the Sun also moves, and its surface bulges and flattens. Now, these motions do not produce audible sounds, but they can be transformed so they can be heard.
Douglas Gough had this idea that it would be possible to use the manifestation of the oscillations on the surface to get information from the solar inside.
He soon had assistance from his PhD student, Jørgen Christensen-Dalsgaard.
Christensen-Dalsgaard, he worked with developing this network of telescope, the gong telescopes. As the Earth rotates, there were always one or several gong stations that could observe the Sun. And so you got a continuous coverage of the solar oscillations.
Using these new measurements, they were now able to visualize what is happening inside the Sun. They determined that the temperature of the Sun's core is 15 million degrees Celsius. Astronomers already knew that gases rise inside the Sun like gigantic bubbles. By studying their effect on the surface, the two laureates could see where the bubbles formed. And they discovered that the Sun has an inner sphere which rotates as a cohesive body. Outside it, the surface layer rotates faster at the equator and slower at the poles.
It's a fantastic discovery that shows that we can get detailed information of what goes on in the inside of the Sun. To see that the Sun's central parts rotates as a solid body, just like a ball, while the exterior has this differential rotation. And that was only possible to observe with the help of solar oscillations.
Then Conny Aerts wanted to use asteroseismology not only to see inside our star, the Sun, but also inside distant stars.
This was, of course, very hard. On the Sun, we can see details. It appears to us as a giant and flaming ball. But the stars are like tiny dots. But Conny Aerts and her team succeeded, and they developed a method.
Thanks to new space telescopes, Conny Aerts got the chance to study surface movements on faraway stars with asteroseismology. Conny Aerts and her team were able to measure changes in stars' brightness and help to determine their sizes and ages. This makes it possible for other scientists to better understand the planets orbiting those stars. And Conny Aerts' work confirmed that red giants have several shells around their core. And she showed the movements in these shells, so scientists can now use asteroseismology to see what elements these shells are made from.
In all, new knowledge about these studied stars will lead to a better understanding of stars, of galaxies, and of galaxy formation. Ultimately, it will teach us more about the whole universe, as stars are so important in the cosmos. Together, these laureates have given us a new way to understand the universe. For this, they are truly worthy recipients of the Crafoord Prize for Astronomy in 2024.
The Crafoord Prize in Astronomy 2024, worth 6 million Swedish krona, is awarded to Douglas Gough, Jørgen Christensen-Dalsgaard, and Conny Aerts. The citation reads, for developing the methods of asteroseismology and their application to the study of the interior of the Sun and of other stars.
I was busy in a workshop in Heidelberg, visiting and battling the snow. And then I got phone calls receiving the Crafoord Prize with three of us. That was a very pleasant surprise. And I was like, kind of like, didn't know what to say. What am I going to do with the money? Like, it's really a community prize. And so I certainly plan to spend at least part of it to support young scientists in our field. It's a whole group of many young scientists, and they should get stimulated to continue and take over from us, because they are the future.
The Crafoord Prize is awarded in partnership between the Royal Swedish Academy of Sciences and the Crafoord Foundation in Lund, Sweden. The Academy is responsible for selecting the Crafoord laureates.